there was a day where we were out west of Mosul getting ready to do a push, and this car comes bumbling down the road, and you know, everybody's like, whoa, because there are lots of car bombs, right? And this guy jumps out, and get this, we're in the middle of nowhere, and he starts saying, help, please help my wife, psychological problems. I thought, what? I just finished a film on trauma, and I thought it was a joke. We went over there, and sure enough, his wife's in the back seat. Her face had been burnt. And he says, please help her. So coming to find out, she has these reoccurring troubled thoughts to cut herself, to burn herself, or to drink poison and die. Oh. And as I talked to her and him, I did an assessment from a trauma standpoint. She definitely was traumatized, but I said, I think this is more than just psychological. I believe there's another realm, and this is evil. And I asked him both. I said, do y'all believe in demons? And I said, yeah. I said, well, I think this is demonic, planting thoughts in your mind to try to have you kill yourself. And I said, do you mind if I pray for you? But the only power I have over evil is in Jesus' name. Can I pray for you? And you know, she said, is Jesus still alive?
Oh, wow.
I'd never heard that in my life.
Wild.
Is Jesus alive? I said, yeah, he is. And wow. He's the one that can free you. I started praying. It was the worst prayer you've ever heard, ever. Because, you know, I got one eye open from the, I'm holding a rifle and I'm going, and doubt's still tagging me, you know. I hope there ain't bombs in this trunk. Prayed the prayer, and man, all of a sudden she starts yelling, my mind is free. Wow. My mind is free. And she was.
That's like the demoniac of the shores of Galilee. Right?